Oh, busy there, busy there.
You can see a film of oil on top, but that's actually the fat and the gelatin that's rendered from the trotters. This is going to be a keema unde that is going to sing more of the flavor of the meat. The nati koli has a bit of the skin clinging onto it, always a good sign. I'm going to get a bit of the skin and also that meat. Mutton pulao.
That's right.
Hi folks, this is Kripal Amana, Gourmet on the Road. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're staying safe and strong. We've just emerged from lockdown here in Namma Bengaluru and things are slowly limping back to, I must say, the new normal. Businesses are grappling with challenges as they try to emerge post-lockdown. And one of the sectors that's most impacted is that of food and beverage. Hotels, restaurants, and tiny eateries. Many of them are fighting for survival. Many of them may not even open doors post-lockdown. So we have decided over the next few weeks to support as many establishments as we possibly can. Eateries, tiny shops, perhaps push carts too, to try and help them find their feet and eke out a livelihood in these very difficult times. So this afternoon, we've set out to lunch at a family-run eatery in North Bengaluru. We have visited this place about a year and a half ago, a few months after they had opened. At that point, what endeared me to this place was this family's dream of showcasing the local flavors of their hometown to us here in Bengaluru. And fittingly enough, the eatery is called Nati Sogudu. So they reached out to us a few days ago, requesting us to come and take a look at what they were doing and also help showcase their work to all of you out there. So therefore, for lunch, we are revisiting Nati Sogudu. And lest you think we've done an episode before, well, we're going to be tasting an entirely new set of dishes as opposed to the dishes that we tasted when we visited them last a year and a half ago. And if you haven't caught that episode yet, I'm going to place a link here and also in the description below. So let's go and lunch at Nati Sogudu. Well, we've arrived at Nati Sogudu in Sahakar Nagar in North Bengaluru. Namaskara.
Namaskara, sir.
So I'm with Naveen and Nagendra, the brothers who, along with your mom
and my wife
and your wife, are the family behind Nati Sogudu. And of course, for those not in the know, Nati Sogudu basically refers to the aroma of the land.
Yes, that's correct.
And that is what they have sought to bring to Namma Bengaluru in the many dishes that they have on offer. So of course, the last time I was here, I remember that by the time I completed my meal, I think the place was packed with customers.
Huh? Yes, it was full.
It was full.
Yeah.
And I think that was soon after you had opened. I think I came here about 6 months after you opened.
That's right.
So you're what? Are you 3 years old now?
We are around 2.5.
2.5 years old. That's right. So I remember that when we came in the last time around, we had a big meal served on a bale ele. And of course, for those of you who have watched that video earlier and say, okay, I've seen Nati Sogudu, well, I'm going to be doing an entirely new set of dishes.
Yeah, that's true.
That's what we're going to be tasting. So people had accepted your food and it was getting popular.
Yes, very much. Yes.
All right.
It was getting popular until the lockdown kicked in.
From COVID-1 to this COVID-2, a lot of tough times we have to face.
And this is your only source of...
Yes, that's true.
Livelihood.
Correct.
And since this was our passion, so we dedicated ourselves completely into this. So
alright.
This is our only business right now.
This is the only business. So it's tough times for most eateries, but I'm hopeful with most of you watching out there and with all your support, I'm sure eateries like Nati Sogudu will regain their glory days in the near future. Moving on to the food, what's on the menu today?
we would like you to taste the dishes that you didn't taste the last time. So we have Nadi chicken curry, chicken curry, mutton chops, and to go with those curries, we would like you to taste idli, tatte idli, and dosa.
And pepper chicken.
And for starters, we would like you to taste pepper chicken.
Mutton fry.
So there certainly is going to be a lot of food on the table. And speaking of all that food, certainly has got my appetite going. It's namdo Nati dishes.
Yes.
Idella nimdo hometown inda.
Hoskote.
So these are dishes that your mom
and my wife.
And your wife. Yes. So it's their recipes.
Yes.
Recipes that have come from their homes.
Yes, that's true.
Which is what you are presenting to Namma Bengaluru.
That's correct, sir.
Fantastic. Can we take a look at the kitchen? See
yes,
what's
sir.
Happening?
Sure.
Let's go to the kitchen here at Nati Sogudu. I can smell the aroma of some of the dishes being prepared. Namaskara.
Namaskara.
Ege dira.
Chanagidi.
ಏನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ? ನಾಟಿ ಕೋಳಿ ಸಾರು. ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್. ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್? ಮಟನ್ ಚಾಪ್ಸ್. ಇದೇನು? ಕೀಮಾ ಬಾಲ್. ಸೊ ಮನೇಲಿ ಸಹ ಇದೇ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಮನೆ ಊಟ ಮನೆ ತರ ಮಾಡುದು. ನೀವು ಮಸಾಲೆ ಎಲ್ಲ
ಪ್ರತಿದಿನ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮ್ಮ ನಮ್ಮ ಅತ್ತಿಗೆ ಬಂದು ಮಸಾಲೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಆ ಮಸಾಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ
And you are the chef here?
Yes.
ಹಳ್ಳಿ ತರ ಟ್ರೈಲೇ ಇದು.
ಹಳ್ಳಿ ತರ?
ಹಳ್ಳಿ ತರ.
ಸೊ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ರೆಸಿಪೀಸ್ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಯಾರು ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ದು? ಇದು
ಇವೆಲ್ಲ ನಾವು ಅವತ್ತಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮಅಮ್ಮ ಹತ್ರ ಕಲ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಬಂದಿರೋದು.
So these are recipes that have come from generations. Andre nimdu amma avrdu amma inda kalthirbodu and even with you as well. So I can certainly tell you one thing that the curries certainly smell rather inviting.
This is chicken curry.
Chicken curry.
It's almost done. Yes, chicken curry.
So idu broiler chicken.
Yes.
So idra color solpa brownish type.
Because for grinding the paste, we put red chilies to it.
Red chilies to it, okay. Enen hogutte nimdu main masale dalli?
Idu main masale andre illa mai soppugalu.
Ha.
Kottambari soppu.
Kottambari soppu. Okay. Mint and coriander amele?
Ella irulli.
Irulli.
Chilli fundi ella tara masalegalu.
Garlic.
Garlic ella haki fry maadi ella grinder maadi.
Coconut.
Coconut.
Almost
coconut.
All our curries are coconut gravy based.
Have coconut gravies.
Yes.
So, suru curries madudu. Amele to make a fry, adu curry piece takkondu.
Yes.
Adu puna fry martira.
We're making Nati chicken fry now.
Nati chicken fry.
Yes. So, I'll be starting off with some oil. This is sunflower oil.
Sunflower oil.
Some curry leaf. And some onions.
So, how many curries do you prepare every day here?
About 6 to 7 curries.
6 to 7 curries. So the 7 curry is the base for everything.
Yes, 7 curry is the base for all the fries that we do. Except for the pepper chicken and chili chicken. They are cooked separately.
Okay.
They are not curry based.
The Nati Koli curry.
And to this.
Coriander powder.
Yes, some coriander powder, some pepper. Pinch of salt.
Okay. Lemon.
Yes.
And then you reduce the gravy.
Yes. The surprising thing is it tastes entirely different from the curry.
That's right. So as you cook it twice,
yes.
I think the flavors get concentrated and also the spices that you add.
Yes.
Whether it's a coriander powder, a bit of pepper, a bit of salt, I think that goes to oomph up the flavors.
Exactly.
I can already smell the aroma of the onions and the curry leaves too.
Absolutely. So this is Nati chicken fry.
Nati koli fry.
Yes.
So, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿರಿಯಾನಿ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಪುಲಾವ್.
Yes, pulav aapke.
So, always a nice feeling when you watch that biryani being revealed after dum. That biryani has spent about 30 minutes soaking up the flavors of that masala.
Exactly. Yes.
In that steam induced bath, and now we're looking forward to the first reveal of the Nati Sogudu mutton pulav.
That's right.
Even with the mask on, with the double mask on, I can smell some of the aromas of that pulao.
So we put the banana leaves on top of the rice. So when we put the coal on top of it, we do not want the rice to get too dry.
So salva moisture irbeko.
Yes.
So what is in the masala?
So that's basically mint, coriander, some garlic, some ginger, and then we put some cloves, cinnamon and pepper.
So the cinnamon, pepper and the cloves are roasted first, dry roasted.
Yes.
Alright, and that goes into the making of the paste. What about green chilies?
Green chilies also.
Okay, onions?
Onions, no, we don't put onions to make a paste. We put onions to sauté.
So you first have the oil that goes in, and in that oil you put some more spices.
We put some bay leaves. Some
fennel
seeds.
Cardamom. Marat mogo.
And cloves we don't put.
Kalua. Stone flour.
Japat.
Maize.
Yeah.
So that's what goes into it, and then once the oil soaks up the aromas, then you add the onions.
Then we add the onions and the tomatoes, and finally the paste which we grinded.
Okay.
And then we put in the meat. And when the meat is cooked, so we put the rice and the pulao is here.
Certainly is a pulao that I'm looking forward to tasting on the table here at Nati Sogadu. Always nice to be greeted by a baale ele at the table. Well, the food is here, so the hat goes off and also the masks, allowing me to take in the aroma of all the dishes that I have in front of me. We'll begin with the chicken, and this of course is the pepper chicken that they have here at Nati Sogadu. This chicken is certainly dark, stained with the pepper, and I'm sure also the spicy flavor of the pepper. Staying with the chicken, we have the Nati Koli Fry. This is a speciality here at Nati Sogadu. Most of the dishes that they do with the chicken are usually the Nati Koli. And I'm told they pay a great deal of attention to the chicken that they get here. And then we have a chicken curry. This is a chicken curry that is stained red with the color of the Kashmiri chili that I'm told goes into the paste for making this curry. Moving on from the chicken to the mutton, we have the mutton fry here. I can see plenty of curry leaves there. We have the mutton chops in this lovely green masala. And then of course we also have a dish that I fondly remember. Of course the last time around I tasted this keema unde in its dry form, but today I'm tasting the keema unde curry, the mutton ball curry. And then this is the leg soup, the trotters. All these dishes I haven't tasted before, with the exception of the mutton pulao. But even in the pulao, I'm told the masala has been changed, that masala has been tweaked. So I'm looking forward to tasting that mutton pulao too. And keeping these curries and fries company is some idli. You have a tatte idli here and also a dosa. I remember soaking the dosa in the curries the last time. And that's certainly something that I'm looking forward to doing this time as well. I think let's make a beginning with the chicken pepper fry and also some Nati Koli fry. So the Nati Koli has a bit of the skin clinging onto it, always a good sign, because you know you're going to be rewarded with that intense flavor of that chicken skin. The fry here is more like a gushy. It's a sort of consistency that will allow you to scoop it up with a chapati or perhaps a dosa as well. Actually, before tasting the fries, I should perhaps taste the soup. Oh, busy there. That soup may otherwise cool down while I'm tasting the chicken starters. You can see a film of oil on top, but that's actually the fat and the gelatin that's rendered from the trotters. You know, sometimes when you're tasting trotters or paya, the flavor and the aroma to a slightly timid palate can be a bit off-putting, because you taste the funkiness of the trotters, of the legs. But out here, you're tasting none of that. What you have is that aroma of that coriander and then that warming flavor of that paya, of that soup. There's a bit of pepper that you're tasting, because you can feel the warmth of the pepper and perhaps some of the other spices that have gone into it. This is a sort of paya that you'd be very happy to meet on a cold morning. That trotter is a texture of jelly. It's a texture where you place it in your mouth and it quite literally dissolves away. There's also a tinge of sourness from the lemon in this kal soup, in this leg soup. I'm certainly very happy to meet this paya. You know, when it comes to a kal soup, you're tasting it perhaps the first thing in the morning, or in my case, it's the first thing that I'm tasting after my 16-hour intermittent fast. So at that point, you don't want the flavors to singe or shock your palate. You want your palate to be gently awakened, and that's exactly what's happening by the gentle, warming, spicy flavors of this kal soup. All that you need is some bisi tatte idli, and the idli too is quite soft, and the salt that's bending, quite literally breaking under its own weight. You want to hold it for a few seconds, not too long, lest you lose that idli to that paya. Place that idli in your mouth, you don't even need teeth. That idli, having soaked up the flavors of that kal soup, quite literally dissolves when placed on your tongue. Delicious. Give me a bowl of leg soup and a tatte idli. Well, that's breakfast for me. A delicious breakfast at that. Let's move next to that pepper chicken. You know, that's a tasty pepper chicken. Again, it's not a preparation that will singe you with the pepper. And I think that's something that they're very mindful of here at Nadi Sogodu. If memory serves me well, I remember tasting a chili chicken the last time around, and it wasn't the sort of chili chicken that would singe your palate. Because after all, the flavors here are the sort that you would encounter in a home, perhaps in a home somewhere in Hoskote, and that's the flavors that they're trying to bring. So even though I'm tasting the pepper chicken, I can certainly feel the warmth of that pepper chicken now engulf my palate. It isn't the sort of heat that sets your mouth on fire. There's also some curry leaf in there. That makes for a tasty chicken appetizer. Let's move on next to that Nati Koli Fry. This of course is a chicken that's double cooked. First it's cooked in the curry and then tossed to make that fry, along with some onions, some curry leaves, some pepper and some of the other spices that we saw going in. And what I like is the fact that there's also some skin that's holding on to that Nati Koli. I'm going to get a bit of the skin and also that meat. You know, there's broiler chicken and then there's that country chicken, the Nati Koli. I just tasted that pepper chicken, which is of course made with the broiler. Tasty as it is, but the moment you place that Nati Koli fry in your mouth, the flavor of the Nati Koli takes over completely. And also because of the fact that this is a curry that's then concentrated into a fry, the flavors are a lot punchier. I love that masala, I love that gashi. There's a creaminess that you taste of the kai, of the coconut. And also because I drizzle a bit of lime over that fry towards the end, you can also taste a tinge of acidity there. For those of you who perhaps are averse to Nati Koli because typically it tends to be tough, the brothers here pay a great deal of attention to the quality of the Nati Koli, or the country chicken that comes in. So I'm told they get the young birds and therefore the meat is tender. In fact, I will even go out on a limb to say that this meat is even more tender than that broiler pepper chicken that I just tasted. So if you like your chicken and you haven't tasted Nati Koli before and you've been averse to it for some reason, this place is certainly where you should get some. There's also a tiny crunch of that kai that I'm tasting in that masala that probably formed the base for that Nati Koli curry that eventually became that Nati Koli fry. Let's move on to that mutton fry next. There's a fair bit of fat in this particular piece, perhaps a bit much for my liking too, but I'm going to go for this piece that has more of the meat with only a bit of fat that's ribboned through it. That meat is pink and tender too. So the flavors that you're tasting are very different. Out here in the Nati Koli fry, I could taste more of the coconut, the dominance of the coconut. But out here, it's the spices. It's perhaps some of the onions that have gone into it. Some of the other spices like the coriander, the jeerige, the pepper. And of course, that crunch of the onion every now and then. That meat is tender yet has a bit of a bite. When you chew on that meat, it rewards you with that masala, with the flavors of the masala. certainly a fair bit of pepper that you're tasting in that. So when you're here, order for your fries, order for your curries, and order for some idli and dosa by the side, because they make for rather great companions to the dishes on offer here. That tatte idli also has a slight tinge of sourness, which also helps cleanse the palate. I'm loving the flavors that the curry leaf imparts to that masala. I'm going to go for some of that dosa. Oh, busy there. This is also a dosa that's rather weighty and also thick. Slightly crunchy on one side and porous to hold all the gravies. But I'm going to make a beginning with that mutton fry. Actually, with the gushy of that mutton fry. Plenty of curry leaves in there. I love the spongy texture of that dosa. You know, this meat is tender that you can peel it off that bone rather effortlessly. I'm loving that mutton fry. Even the fat has rendered beautifully into that curry, and that fat is soft. It's not the sort of fat that will tug at your bite. It's the sort of fat that will readily embrace your bite. Of the three dishes that I've tasted thus far, I'm definitely going to return for that mutton fry and also that naati koli fry. The chicken pepper fry was tasty too, but then once you taste that naati koli, I think the flavors of that naati koli quite simply overwhelm everything else that broiler had to throw at your palate. Let's move on next to that koli saru. By the way, they also do a fantastic bassaru here. I remember tasting it the last time, the naati koli bassaru. If you want to know what that bassaru is like, definitely take a look at that last video. I was quite tempted to order it again, but because I wanted to showcase some different dishes here at Naati Sogadu, I desisted from ordering that again. But if you like your bassaru, they do a great version of the naati koli bassaru. This, of course, is a chicken curry made with the broiler. This is a sort of curry that you want to allow that dosa to rest in, to luxuriate in for a few moments. Well, that's a tasty curry. You, of course, have the coconut that goes into it and the spices, but what you can definitely taste is the aroma of the fennel in that curry. And that chicken seems to have soaked up the flavors of the curry. Out here in the kitchens, Nagendra and his mom and his sister-in-law, they make only about 5 or 6 curries every day, and those curries then also form the basis for some of the fries. But they take the making of those curries quite seriously. And when you taste those curries, it's quite evident in the flavor that greets you on the palate. I'm sure if I were to go to their home in Hoskote and savor a meal, I'm sure these are pretty much the kind of flavors that I would be tasting. That curry is thick and creamy too with the coconut. I'm told they use Kashmiri chilies in this, in the masala, to give that curry that very inviting reddish brown sort of a hue. All the flavor of that chicken and the spices is there in that curry itself. The dosa serves well to mop up the curry and also leaves behind that tiny whisper of a crunch that it imbibes by virtue of being roasted on both sides on that tawa. Let's go next for that keema unde curry. You can taste the flavor of the coriander, the freshness of the coriander in that curry. There's of course also that kai, and that kai makes its presence felt on the palate in that teeny weeny bit of a crunch. And I think there's also some green chili in there somewhere, because you can taste the pointed heat of the green chili. What I like in this keema unde is that there's also bits of fat clinging on to that keema unde. You know, this is going to be a keema unde that is going to sing more of the flavor of the meat. I think they also use a bit of the meat fat to combine that mince, to bring that mince together into an unde. You know, some places you're tasting the keema unde, you'll taste more of the binder, the gram flour, etc. But out here, you're tasting more of the meat laced with the voluptuous texture of the fat. And I think there's also some egg that comes in along with some gram flour to bring it together. But you're tasting mostly the flavor of the meat. I'm enjoying it so much that I definitely feel like I should go for another Keema Unde. The last time I tasted the Keema Unde here was in a fry form. I think it was a Keema Unde pepper fry. So of course when you're tasting a fry, a pepper fry, the flavors are a lot more concentrated. I think because the meat cooks twice, first in that curry, and then as it's tossed with the onions, the curry leaves, some coriander powder, some lemon, etc., that meat takes on a bolder flavor. In the curry, the Keema Unde is quite gentle. But you can certainly taste a slight spicy tinge of that green chili every once in a while. That's been ground into the masala. There's also some tomato there, and that tomato helps to impart slightly sweetish acidity to the dish. That whisper of a crunch of that dosa I find quite endearing. So that dosa is rather convenient to mop up that curry, and that's what you taste first when you place that dosa in your mouth. But towards the end, you taste that slightest whisper of a crunch from the roasting of that dosa. If you love your naati uta, these are certainly the dishes to be tried here. And I think what's also special about this restaurant is typically when you're eating naati uta, the environments are such that you go there, get your food, eat quickly and run out of the place. Whereas out here, the family is presenting these very traditional, very rustic flavors in an environment that you can linger on with your friends and family. And I think that's where Naati Sogodu holds an edge too. The fact that you can savor these hearty rustic curries in an environment that allows you to linger over some of these flavors. Let's move on to that mutton chops curry. This masala is certainly a lot more punchy than that Keema Unde curry. I can taste the flavor of the pepper and of course the green masala. That meat is tender and pink. The sort of meat that you don't need teeth to bite into. That fat quite literally dissolves away. Because the flavor of the mutton here is a lot more punchy as it's in this form with the fat, with the bone, etc. As opposed to that Keema Unde where it's largely the meat. The flavors of the curry here too have been kept punchy. So you've got that green masala, but there's plenty of the green chili, there's plenty of the pepper that you're tasting in the flavors of the dish. Mop up some dosa, quite literally dissolve the dosa in that curry and simply place in your mouth. Time now to turn our attention to this handi of mutton pulao here. There's a motte that's cresting that biryani, that pulao actually. But I think I've had enough protein for today. Let's savor more the rice and a piece of meat or two. So this is a short grain siraga sambar rice. The pulao is quite moist. This isn't the sort of pulao where you're tasting one ingredient or one spice over the other. But you get the feeling, the paste that they incorporate into the pulao, be it the green paste, be it some of the spices, are the sort that lend their flavors in harmony to that rice. That meat is certainly quite soft, quite tender. I find the texture of this pulao quite moist. It's the sort where the rice and the meat combine together in a juicy mouthful. What's interesting in this pulao is that the meat hasn't dried out. Sometimes when you're tasting the pulao, that meat has imparted all its juices, all its flavors to the rice, so much so that it's left bereft. It's left holding on to none of those meaty flavors for itself. But out here, you can savor the rice by itself. That is uplifted with all the spicing, with all the ingredients that have gone into it, including the wet paste. And then the meat in itself is still holding on to its juicy, fat-laden flavors. I think that's what's quite interesting about this mutton pulao here. This is definitely a pulao where overall, the flavors of the fresh herbs that go into it, whether it's the coriander, the mint, are more apparent. I think the spices serve to deepen or heighten some of the flavors. I think Nagendra has certainly worked on this pulao. Last time I tasted this pulao, it was tasty, but I don't remember reaching for that meat over and over again. I love that fat, that buttery fat that's ribboned through the meat. Times have been very difficult for eateries, especially in the last year and a half. I think most of them, they're barely getting by. But in the midst of all the challenges that I'm sure the family here must be facing, it's heartening to see that they've held on to the quality of their fare. In fact, as I go back to the dishes that I tasted the last time around, in some cases the dishes have perhaps gotten better, like that mutton pulao. ಏನಿದು
ಜಾಮೂನ್
ಜಾಮೂನ್
ಹೋಮ್ಮೇಡ್
ಹೋಮ್ಮೇಡ್ ಜಾಮೂನ್ ಯಾರು ಮಾಡಿದ್ದು
ನಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿಯವರು
ಓ ಸಮ್ ಹೋಮ್ಮೇಡ್ ಜಾಮೂನ್ ಟು ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಆ ಮೀಲ್ ಐ ಎಮ್ ಸರ್ಟನ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸೇ ನೋ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ವೆರಿ ನೈಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ಸಮ್ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಈಟಿಂಗ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಜಾಮೂನ್ ದೇರ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಮಚ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಖೋವಾ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಲಿಟಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಝೀರೋ In fact, this jamun reminds me of the sort of jamun that my mom would make. And I think that's the beautiful thing about eating in restaurants like these. It's the sort of food that you would eat at home, at someone's home. If that someone was blessed with a family that could churn out naughty delicacies like this. It would be an understatement to say that I've enjoyed my meal here quite thoroughly. I think each of the dishes that I've tasted have been outstanding. Whether it was a naati koli fry, the chicken saru, the mutton chops curry, the keema unde curry, and not to forget that mutton pulao. It's heartening to see that the brothers, the family, have held on to the standards, have held on to the flavors of the dishes, and also in terms of the ingredients that go into the dishes. Never have I tasted naati koli as tender as the meat that I tasted in that naati koli fry. Times are difficult, times are indeed tough. Many eateries, many restaurants are finding it extremely hard to eke out a living. In a situation like that, when you're concerned whether you will be able to see the next day, it's indeed wonderful to see that the family behind Naati Sogadu has done all that they can to maintain the culinary traditions that come from their parents. So if you're looking to savor some flavor of the land, some Naati flavor of the land, definitely find your way to Naati Sogadu here in Sahakar Nagar. I hope you've enjoyed this episode of Gourmet on the Road. Until the next time, take care, stay safe, stay very, very safe. And happy eating. If you'd like to support the work that we do at Food Lovers TV, do consider joining our membership community on YouTube by hitting the join button below or on the home page. You could pledge a nominal sum and receive special privileges like behind the scenes footage, shoot updates, access to live Q&As, and a lot more. You could support us on a Patreon page as well. For more info, check out the links in the description below. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, share, and leave a comment below. Happy eating!